Hi guys, so earlier this month I did a video about whether or not you should buy an iPhone 13 mini in current year, and I was really impressed with how many views it received, over 2,000, so thank you so much for that. In this video I'll be replacing the battery, so let's get started. So I've had my iPhone 13 mini for 18 months now, and I'm starting to charge my iPhone a lot more than I used to, about 2 to 3 times a day. According to my battery health in settings, it's currently at 89%. Now many people are saying that a battery replacement should only occur when the health is in the lower 80s, but I've also experienced lagging lately when using certain apps. Batteries degrade far quicker these days because we do so much with our phones when compared to the earlier days of using smartphones. One thing I've learned about battery replacements over the years is to not cheap out. So I came upon this on Amazon for £30. And it has everything I need. I also bought some isopropyl alcohol on eBay, as the battery can be quite difficult to remove. I've previously replaced iPhone batteries. 3 years ago, I replaced my iPhone 11 battery, but in doing so, I damaged the battery. This time, I want to do things properly, and so I'll be using the iFixit guide. The first thing I need to do is to remove two small screws near the speaker grills. Next, I have to remove the adhesive holding the screen onto the phone itself. This is a very strong adhesive, so it took me quite a while to loosen it using a hairdryer. I also used some suction cups to pry the screen in order to lodge the picks inside. This took an incredible amount of time and patience. Once open, I have to remove one screw to detach the plate covering the battery connector. These screws are tiny, and so I have my trusted magnetic mat to ensure I don't lose any. I then use some pliers to remove the plate. I can now use a plastic spudger to disconnect both the screen and the battery. I did the same for the second plate just above the processor. This allows me to finally remove the display from the chassis. To gain access to the battery tabs, I then remove the speaker by removing 4 screws. At the bottom of the battery, there are 2 tabs. I began gently removing them. Unfortunately, I didn't manage to get it all, and so I used the isopropyl alcohol to gently dissolve the adhesive strips. Once the alcohol did its magic, I gently inserted some picks to pry the battery out. I had to be careful, as one false move, the battery would be irreversibly damaged. The battery eventually came out with ease. To avoid the dreaded non-genuine Apple battery message, I will be using my QianiLi iCopy, which now has a battery reading board for my iPhone 13 mini. However, when I placed the battery on the connector, I began experiencing issues. After a few tries, I wasn't able to read the battery. Perhaps it had gotten damaged, but after close inspection, the battery looks fine. I will certainly be taking this machine back for a full refund. The new battery will still function as normal, but without any battery health. I then began installing the adhesive to the battery before installation. Once installed, I can now remove the existing adhesive, ready for the new one. But before I do that, I need to turn the iPhone on to see if all is well. And it is. I can now reattach all the cables, screws, and plates, and install the new adhesive. I can visibly see the non-genuine battery message, but this is to be expected. By doing this battery replacement, I have saved 30%. Thanks for watching, and as always, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And I will see you in the next video.